Okay, this is, thank you for being able to speak about this new online expert tool guide on data management that we have developed the past year. It's not yet finished, so I'm providing here a sneak preview to what is about to come out next month. So we're very busy in doing all kinds of updates at the moment, based on researchers' reviews. So we're going to, who is we? So that's SESTA. SESTA is a consortium of European social sciences data archives. These archives, all over Europe, provide workshops, not all of them, but some of them provide workshops on research data management. Some are linked with libraries, universities, and university libraries. And not all of them can provide this workshop, and they said, well, why not, as a working group training within SESTA, create one online tool for social scientists, so not research data management for all disciplines, but for this specific discipline. What do we know from our workshops that researchers need? And we would like to have an online tool that we can all tap into, so all these different countries can make use of that. So this is the homepage. I'm Ellen Leenarts, I'm from Dans. It's an institute in the Netherlands for long-term access to digital research resources. And we are not only a social science archive, but many of the partners within SESTA are. So for example, Scott, who is in the back of the room, is from the UKDS, and there are, not sure, Jenny is not here, but there are some other members of this. Here you see what SES is all about. What's important is it's since June it has become an ERIC. It's financed by the ministry, so it's a very steady financing system. We want to improve quality, of course, of data and metadata. We want to improve the training that is there. We want to have more discoverability of data. And we want to have, what did I want to say? Oh yeah, a wide selection of comparable data. I think it also links very much to this online module. So I already said we wanted to combine our best practices as workshop trainers. And but we also saw, of course, it's 2 years ago now that we wrote this proposal. There was a lot of talk about data management, about research data management. How do we create these DMPs that more and more funders want us to create? So we thought there was actually a need also there that was also expressed during our workshops. It's a one-year project. It started in December 2016 with a big kickoff. It actually started in January, but we wanted to start before because we were all excited. All these trainers came, and we started with lots of brainstorming about topics that would interest everyone in all these different countries, so not only in the UK or not only in the Netherlands, but everywhere else as well. And then we thought about the structure of the online module or the course. And we all knew the Essentials for Data Support, which is an RDNL online course. I'm not sure, do you know this course as well? Because it's for data supporters, and we most of us really liked it, but it's for data supporters and not for researchers. So we are inspired by that. And after a few months of brainstorming and things, putting on paper and things, leaving that aside, and we said we needed a face-to-face workshop. We all came together, and then we decided on what chapters will we have. It will be an online guide and not a course, because it's really a challenge to create a course in with so many partners in half a year. Then what is chapters based on? We brought in someone who knows Marina Noordegraaf from Verbeeldingskracht, who helped us. What is your target audience? Because we are also invited for this workshop in we invited a couple of researchers and said, well, these are our plans. What do you think? And they immediately said, well, you should be clear about your target audience because it's too broad. It should be early career, really. So that's what we decided upon. And they had, of course, lots of other comments that we picked. Now, just this month, or October, we had this feedback period. But the online content is almost ready. So they had a look at it. It's 15 hours of content. Researchers, trainers, and data management specialists. And we got hundreds of pages of feedback now. A little bit too much, but we will try to incorporate as much as possible. This is just to give you an example of the product statement. We wanted, because there's also Mantra and there is this Essentials for Data Support, we know that it's there. We want to distinguish from that because we're discipline specific and we are more European. So we give a lot of focus on European diversity. So these are the, I think, we came up with this cycle because it is linked to the topics that we wanted to address. So first the planning, what should be all in the planning of your data, organizing document process. I think you understand why, how this came about. Then we had some recurring chapter sections. Like I said, we have local diversity, so we try to include information from different countries. So how is, for example, the GDPR that's coming up, how is that handled within Austria, how is that handled within the UK, and so on. Then we another recurring chapter section is Adapt Your DMP. So for every chapter that you saw, we will say, well, this means that if you are creating your DMP or you have your DMP, this is what you should focus on, and this is how you could adapt it. We also created a checklist that covers everything that is in the module. And it is, of course, also inspired by all the other checklists that are already there. So we try not to miss anything. Just to give you another sneak preview of pages, just examples. You know about FAIR, it's already been spoken about. We have tried not to put too many text into FAIR in this module because so many things are happening at the moment. And otherwise, everyone will see that it's created in 2017. And so we wait till that's more crystallized. Then some quotes from the feedback, which are really fresh. Oh, this is really strange. Anyway, there was a lot of positive feedback, and we were really satisfied. There was also feedback like it's too detailed, and others say it's not detailed enough. So, but I think that was really good. When I read those feedback, I thought, yes, another one that says too detailed, and yes, another one that says it's not detailed enough. I was really proud of ourselves. So what is happening now? There is a flyer. I don't know if you know it. The important thing about the flyer is that there is the address on it where it will be live in a month's time. So that's over there. So if you didn't take the flyer, you can also talk to me about it. What we will do next year, after we've all finished up this module, we will have a sort of trainer-trainer package, and we will do a trainer-trainer workshop. That means for SESTA, social science trainers in RDM, who would like to use the module, because we also want to give some guidance on how to use the module in your local workshops. These are all the people that worked on it, or institutes, all members of SESTA, and I think this was my last slide, so.
Okay. 40 seconds left for questions. Questions, anyone?
Yeah, well, from the dance perspective, I'm familiar, but not really from the SESTA. We didn't do anything with that on the module.
Okay.
So this is, yeah, no.